This is a Be Kind to Pets veterinary educational video sponsored by Toa Payoh Vets. Five previous C-sections done for breeder William Goh. One Maltese, one Dachshund, and three Corgis.
Today is 14th, right?
14 January 2016.
Okay, this is a follow-up visit to the breeder's farm, Mr. William Goh, to check on the puppies after caesarean section and the outcome of five dams. The caesarean section done by Toa Payoh Vets. Okay, this is the latest one. These puppies are how old?
4 days old.
4 days old, and this is the dam herself. And according to the breeder, Mr. Goh, there was a very small one. Where's the small one? Furthest away, right? Is it not suckling the milk? Is it suckling?
Suckling, but no good. Eh? Always pushed off by others.
Because the other big ones are bullies, in a sense.
Very strong.
So but there's one nipper there. He didn't go and suckle. He didn't go.
One, two, three, four. The always the small one is missing.
No, the small one at the back in the far left, right? Is it the left one?
No.
The left one?
The tiny one. No, at the back.
Where's the small one? Okay, we show the small one. Is it sucking?
Yes.
Sucking. So this small one is always bullied by the big one.
It's all pushed away.
Pushed away. So you see the puppy sucking now. See? So the breeder must always keep an eye close and on the puppies. Okay, so this 4 days old. The dam is very active and healthy, producing milk and eating. Okay, now we go to the second dam. Okay, second dam is the Dachshund. Open the gate, the Dachshund. Okay, how old are the puppies, the Dachshund puppies?
23 days old.
Two were done by caesarean section, the two black ones. These are quite nice and round. And the puppy is okay, right?
Yeah, they feel okay.
Then the Dachshund also is nursing.
Survive puppy one, okay.
Is nursing two corgi. Three were delivered by C-section, but one died because it was in distress. Okay. This for the Dachshund. Now we talk about the third corgi, then caesarean section at Toa Payoh Vets. These are the two puppies. One here, and then the other one is here, nursed by this Dachshund. Okay. This is the corgi dam. Produce how many puppies?
Seven
puppies, and she had no milk, right?
Got milk.
She got milk, but there were too many.
Small are different. Two small transfer to here, to the small dam.
Too many, so the breeder transferred two here. So the other five?
Follow the original mother.
Follow the dam back home to the other breeder. So these two left behind are the smaller ones. And they look very well fed, you can see. So how many days old is that?
17 days.
17 days old, can you remember? Okay, this is how it 17 days old look like. And they're quite content sleeping here. You can see here. There. So now we go to the fourth one. Fourth one, come. The fourth one is this one, right?
Yeah.
Okay, come. Fourth one is how many weeks old? About 2 months old.
These are 8 weeks old.
8 weeks old corgi puppy. There are three. One is outside. One is outside, right? One is outside.
Yeah,
there are three. Okay, this one is also delivered by caesarean section at Toa Payoh Vets. Only thing the dam passed away. And so they were nursed by, I think, the Spitz. Come close to them, the Spitz. So this is the fourth one. Now we go to the next one. Yeah. This is the third puppy. It's quite fat. Okay, this is the 8 weeks old. Yeah. This is the number three. Just now there were two there. Okay, where's the another case? Okay, there's the mother. The eight puppies died. Okay. Okay. Because she got no milk, right? This one. No milk, right? Last time.
Yeah, no milk.
No milk. So she couldn't nurse the eight puppies. And what happened? The puppies give to other dams. Others, and then. They all died.
Okay.
How many days?
Five days over.
So within 5 days. So what happened was this one was caesarean was okay, the puppy was okay, right?
Yeah.
Eight puppies.
Okay.
Mother got no milk. No milk, huh?
Yeah.
So this one is the last of the five cases done by Toa Payoh Vets Nov. And you can see the dam is The dam is okay. Caesarean section was okay. These eight puppies were okay, right? After caesarean or during
five days. The mother okay.
5 days after caesarean. So the mother had no milk, right?
No milk.
No milk. So these are all the different outcome. So this concludes the farm visit to Willem Go. January 14, 2016.
That's a summary table of the dams and their puppies as of 14 January 2016. Follow-ups are important as the vet can observe the client's point of view and improve in the future. In this case, the breeder had some important feedback for the vet concerning the type of suture used. There are two types of sutures that can be used. Number one is Monosyn, which is made from nylon. It is stiff and not soft. It was used in the case of the Maltese. Number two is Follw-up, which is thread-like and softer. It was used in the case of the Dachshund. The Maltese had simple interrupted stitches with Monosyn sutures 4 days ago. Because of this follow-up, we now know that the breeder was not happy with the result.
Okay, breeder, show me the stitches, okay?
Yeah, the stitches, the plastic is here.
Oh, they take away the tissue, lah?
No.
Take already?
No, the tissue,
the plaster.
That plaster that they cover.
Take already?
They have to take.
Take out already?
This one have to remove.
This tissue no need to remove, it will dissolve, yeah?
No,
It will.
Usually, you is using that the other...
No, mine is horizontal mattress.
Ah.
He is using simple, okay, this is appositional suture.
Then this one you have to remove. This one you put the puppy's eyes.
Too sharp. The end.
This one is plastic.
This one
have to remove.
See, my horizontal mattress is away from the incision line.
You
do, you cut it short.
No, cut it short also, the puppy pop. You see, it's so sharp.
I will tell him.
This is no good. That's olden day system. The new system is inside.
Subcuticular, you're talking about it.
You also old system.
Okay.
I brought him one.
Okay, now I know what he means. He just doesn't like the simple interrupted suture because the ends hurt.
Of this plastic, you see. But our hand touch all the
sharp.
No good.
So the best is don't use monosyn. I use a poly braided
now,
one.
Nowadays, nobody using this one already except those old.
Got. But it's just that they are talking about subcuticular one. He's talking about subcuticular.
I already told him.
Okay, I'll talk to him.
The Dachshund had subcuticular stitches with Follw-up sutures 23 days ago, and the breeder preferred this.
Later. You can see the different methods of stitching now. That's good for you.
That's why he learned. He come here and learn. I tell you right to the point. Everyone is knows. They don't know. I know everything.
This is the oldest breeder in Singapore.
If we have food next time,
he will give you feedback. He'll give you feedback. He'll give feedback. This is it. Okay, go and see. This is supposed to be done by me. Now, normally I use the non-filament, non-monofilament. I use the nylon one. No, I use the braided one, poly.
The full inside one.
Okay, this is how many days only? It seems to have disappeared.
This is.
Yeah. Or 14.
23 days.
Already?
Almost a month.
No, you even after 3-4 days also don't see anything.
Okay, I can see the textbook one just now. This is the non-textbook one.
She go and learn what up.
No, I teach her the non-textbook one. This one I just take a very small, so that just the width of the puppy's head. and body so that the incision is, I don't exteriorize the uterus. So I also learned something new. So the reason is that the monosyn are actually nylon, absorbable nylon, and the ends are very sharp, poking the puppies when they suckle. I use polysop. Polysop is the, it's more like a thread filamentous.
And then it's inside.
No, I didn't put inside. I do horizontal mattress, which the breeder didn't see. So the sutures are at one end, but they are, because they are soft like cotton thread, so it doesn't affect the puppy's suckling. Whereas the nylon in the Maltese is sharp. You see what I mean? Like stiff. So that's the difference.
Each case is different, giving vets access to a wealth of information. Effective feedback can be given by clients to further hone a vet's skills. At home versus inpatient behavior of the animal is different, and follow-ups allow vets to investigate the differences. Having follow-ups allows for better clinical management, whereby management issues like nursing care can be addressed. For example, the breeder complaining about the stitches in this case. Follow-ups also strengthen customer relationships. Vets can learn from the client's point of view. The importance of a follow-up should not be overlooked. If there is no time for a direct visit, a phone call, SMS, or emailing a client should suffice. This improves communication skills and creates loyalty with the clients.